Okay, so once again, very good day to everybody present here. I think with the last class, we actually dealt with the Hello World app. We discussed about the initial setup, we discussed more about the execution part, the views conf as well as the URLs as well. And then we actually discussed with the Git and Bitbucket as well. This particular class, we would discuss more about the Pages app. So here we will be discussing more about the how we would make up the initial setup. Then we will discuss about the templates, the class-based views, URLs, how to add an about page, and then we will discuss more about the templates and about the extending and enhancing the templates. Then we would discuss about the various tests. Then the traditional Git and the Bitbucket, because that's what is the future of the Hello World as well as the Python Django as well. And then we would discuss between local as well as production templates as well. Next, we would discuss about Heroku and then the additional files associated with it. And if there is time, we would discuss more about the deploy function and then we would conclude. So this is especially for you, my dear students and young researchers. And you can reach me at dr.kusra.anand@gmail.com. So before beginning any session, like just devote at least some 1 minute or maybe 2 minute time to thank God for giving this golden opportunity to deliver this useful session, to share my knowledge among my fellow national and international participants. So this is what we are going to discuss. As I have told you, we are going to go with the initial setup of the Pages app. Then, like the previous class, like the Hello World app, we would have a Django welcome page. Then we would discuss more about the templates, the class-based views, and then the views conf, and then the URLs, how to add an about page, extending the templates, and then we would discuss more about the tests, Git and the Bitbucket, and then we would compare local as well as production functions. And then we will discuss more about the Heroku, and if there is time, we will discuss about the additional files as well as the deploy function. Of course, in this particular class, we will discuss more about the independent work as well. So before beginning today's class, I would like to ask you whether you went through the materials in the Google Classroom. Did you go through the materials?
You mean in a Google Classroom?
Yeah, Google Classroom. Did you go through the assignment, the independent
yes,
works that are posted?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
We are working on it.
Okay. So a deadline has been fixed to you, so prepare accordingly. Okay. And here afterwards, I believe maybe I'll be posting the materials in the Google Classroom. Is that fine for you? What is your suggestion? Should I have to post it in the Telegram group or post it in the Google Classroom?
I think it's better to use Google Classroom.
Google Classroom, because the thing is that with the case of your mobile or maybe the desktop or laptop, maybe that the data would have been erased. Maybe for example, if you're formatting your mobile or maybe the desktop or laptop, maybe the data gets erased. So if I post it in the Google Classroom, you can access it anytime and you can learn accordingly. Is that fine for everybody?
Can you repeat, please?
No. If I post all the materials in the Google Classroom instead of Telegram app, is that fine for everybody?
Yes, of course.
Okay, right. So we begin today's class with the Pages app. We discuss more about the initial setup. So whenever you are going with the initial setup, first of all, like in the previous topics with the case of Hello World app, you have to create a new directory for our code. And then you have to install the Django latest version. So I think in the last class, we actually discussed more about the virtual environment and then the pipeline functions. So what you have to do, you have to create a new directory and then you have to install the Django in a new virtual environment. Okay. So the first step would be creating a new Django project and then you have to create the new Pages app. So that's our particular topic of today's class. Okay. So you have to create a new Pages app, and then you have to update the settings.py function. Okay. So you have to make sure that you are not working in an existing virtual environment. So make sure you clear all the existing data before starting anything. Okay. So you have to install Django in a new virtual environment. Okay. So you can tell if there's anything in the parentheses before your command line prompt. Okay. So if that is the case, what you have to do is you have to simply exit out of the existing virtual environment and you have to go to a new virtual environment. So this is the command line I'm talking about. We are going to create a new Pages directory. Okay. And it has to be in its own directory and you have to include this command line. Okay. For example, to create a command directory, you go for $cd slash desktop and then you have to make a directory mkdir pages. Okay. And then create directory within pages. Okay. And then you have to create a maybe install the Django in a new virtual environment. So you have to go for pip env function. Okay. Pipeline environment function install Django equal to 2.1. What is this 2.1? Yeah, very good. The version of Django. Okay. But as far as Django is concerned, the latest version is 3.9.7. Okay, that's the latest version. But still, we are going with the basic version. Okay. In that, you have to go with the shell function. So, pipe env shell. And then, what you do, you have to create the pages. Okay. What you are trying to create, Django hyphen admin start project pages underscore project. So, you are going to create a pages app with this one. And then, you are going to manage the settings function. So, pages within parenthesis pages dollar python manage.py start app pages. Okay, so you are going to manage.py, you are going to go with the settings manage function with the guise of this python. So this is how you are going to go with the initial setup of the pages app. So with this case, generally you can use the pages maybe with the case of representing the virtual environment. For example, if I'm trying to use a pages app, then I shall include my unique name, maybe pages hyphen unoyeqne. I'm creating this one. Okay. Maybe if you create, you would have like pages hyphen, maybe xyz. Okay. And then maybe e. It is actually a combination of small letters, capital letters, and numbers. Okay. So you can create authentication. You can create privacy in such a way that your environment name would be unique. For example, I have created it this way. You can also create it maybe in some other way also. Okay. So what you're going to do, you're going to open your text editor and you're going to navigate to the settings py function and then you have to add the pages app at the bottom of the project. Okay. Right. So this is how what you create add the pages app under the installed apps. Okay. So adding the pages app definitely would fetch you more functions associated with the installed apps. With the case of the settings function, with the installed apps, we have like different functions, like maybe six functions are there, like contribute.admin, contrib.authentication, contrib.contentTypes, contrib.sessions, contrib.messages, contrib.staticFiles. Okay, and after that, you end it with the pages.apps.pages.config. Okay. So whenever you are going to start the local web server, you have to do it in this way. Within parentheses, you type pages because you are creating a pages app. Dollar python manage.py run server. So whenever you are going to go with run server, it will have the, you know, the local functions associated with it. Right. So what? After this run server, what you are going to do, you are going to navigate to this URL, HTTP 127.0.0.1:8000. So when you are going for this website URL, then you will have a Django welcome page on your home page. The install works successfully. Congratulations. So if you are able to get this message, then you can see that the Django has been corresponding Python function has been associated with the Django function is correctly installed. Now we are going to discuss with the help of the templates, okay? Like with the help of the templates, you can include like individual HTML files. Like we can have a view to a web page specified by the URL, okay? And you can repeat this pattern over again and again. For example, you can use like the templates for individual HTML files or maybe views or maybe URLs as well. So actually with the case of the templates, it's actually a format where you try to include the HTML files. URLs is nothing but the address of the particular location. Okay, so it's going to control the initial route, maybe the entry point into a page, okay, how many views the page has, okay, and what template it follows with respect to the HTML. Okay, so normally web pages would be having like a separate database model. So it is actually the view that does much of the work to decide what data is available to the template. So every template has a particular format, and the web pages rely on this database model where what we try to include in the template. Okay, so we have templates, views, then URL. Generally, for every Django web page, you have the templates, views, and URL. Okay, but maybe it will take some repetition before you try to picturize it or summarize it accordingly. Okay, but the thing is that even for the beginners, Django beginners, you will have a doubt like where you need to keep the templates directory. Okay, right. So Django looks within each app for templates. Okay. In our pages app, it will expect a home.html template. Okay, only within that home.html template, you will have these templates. So it's a default version where you try to include the templates. It is built installed in the install apps. This is the templates layout. Within the pages, you have templates. In the templates, you have like home.html. Okay, so which means that we have to create a new template directory. A new directory with the name of the app, and then you will have pages, and then finally our template itself, which is nothing but home.html. So only within this home.html you will have like several templates, and only thing is that it will have a periodic repetition structure. Okay, right, because the Django template loader wants to make sure that it is the correct template and how it is programmed to look for them. For example, if we directly go to a particular location, okay, it shows that it's too easy, but the thing is that make it a little more complicated, so make sure that it is the correct template directly. So that's the reason you have a repetition structure: pages, templates, pages, home.html. So in the case of templates, in the case of structuring the templates in a Django project, what you have to do, you have to create a single project level template directory which is available to all apps. So we try to include this project level template directly in the apps. Okay, so what you are going to do, you are going to access the settings.py file, and you have to make sure that what you are trying to create is a project level folder for creating a project level template directory. Okay, so first of all, you have to exit all the existing environment. What you do, you press Ctrl and C simultaneously so that you can quit the server, and then what you have to do, you have to create a project level folder. Okay, so this project level folder, you call it with the templates, and then you include the HTML file home.html. so this is where you create a template, okay, project level templates directory within a project level folder. So in the case of the templates, we include the command line make directory templates, and then we are going to go with the touch template slash home.html. This is actually getting in access with the templates within the home.html file. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to update this settings.py function. You have to tell the Django with respect to the project level for the templates. So here what we are going to include pages underscore project slash settings.py. We are going to access the settings.py function, and then with the case of templates you include DIRS. Okay, we are going to make the with regards to the directory function under the templates DIRS, okay, colon, and then start place os.path.join base underscore directory comma templates. Okay, this is actually a new function, and then you are going to close the brace and end it with a this square brace. So this is how you include the templates function. You make a directory and then you get access with the templates within the home.html.
Right. So the templates function, which we were actually trying to discuss about with the case of DIRS. Okay. So you can include a simple headline to our home.html file. What we are going to do in the template slash home.html, you are going to create a home page. So our template with the case of creation of the home page is complete. Okay. Next, what you have to do, you have to configure the URL and you are going to view this URL. So for that, what we are going to do, we are going to go with a class based views. Okay. So class based views are the Django versions which we had already installed. It is only shipped with the function based views, but we are not having the class based views. Okay. What you are going to do, you are going to write a view which lists all the objects in a model. Okay. And write a view which displays only one detailed item from the model. So you are going to list all the objects, and then you have to list only one detailed item from a model. Okay. So this is how you are going to create a view, nothing but a class based view. Okay. So function-based generic views are actually they create patterns or maybe streamline development of common patterns, and there was no easy way where you can customize these function-based generic views. Okay, so that's the reason to make it more easily available, and in order to list the give the details about each and every item in a model, we have introduced the class-based generic views. Okay. So you can extend these views for the common cases as well. So classes, they are definitely a very important part in the Python. So what you are going to do, you are going to include the code from django.views.generic import template view. Okay. So in the class homepage view, you are going to include the template view, and the template name you are going to give it as phone.html. Okay. So it will have like all the logic that is required to display our template, and definitely we can specify the template name as home.html. So this is how you are going to import the template view, and in the home page view you are going to include the template name home.html. And then after viewing it with the case of the class based views, next we are going to go with the URL confs. Okay. So we can make the update in two locations. First of all, you are going to update the project level URLs PUI file, okay, to point at the pages tab, and within the pages we have to match the views to the roots. Okay. So what you are going to do from the django.contrib import admin function, and from django.urls in the contrib function, you are going to include the urls function import path. I think with the video you would have seen, okay, import the path function, and then include with a new function. Okay. And then if you discuss in the video with the case of the patterns, and within that in the patterns you would have discussed path admin admin.site.urls. okay, so you are including the path. Okay, you are including the pages.urls file. Okay, this pages.urls file you are going to include it, and then you are going to close this square brace. So this is how you include the urls pattern out of the Django contrib and then Django urls function. So after making all these steps, you have to go with the class based views and the URL configure function. So we are going to add include on the second line to point on the existing URL. What you are going to do, you are going to include the command line within braces. You include pages dollar, you are going to access the pages, so touch pages slash urls.py. okay, so what you are going to do, you are going to access this django.urls from django.urls import path. After importing the path, you are going to go with the importing the home page view. Okay, and then you are going to define the url patterns path home page view as a view and then name equal to home. So you are going to include all this, the path function, and then you are going to go with the home page view. Next, you are going to define the URL patterns. So this is how you are going to point to the URL pattern in the pages app. So this is after setting up this class based views and then URLs and then pointing the URLs in the pages app, you are going to access this home page. So when using the class based views, you can also add a underscore view function at the end of the view name, and then when we are completely done, we are going to run the web server. So we are going to go for $python manage.py run server. Okay, so either after this run server, you can type 888. So in the video you would have seen. Okay, and then if you type the URL http 127.0.0.1:8000, so you will have this home page. Okay, so this is how you are going to view the URLs with the pages app. After creating this pages app, next comes a very important part. You are going to add an about page. So we have created a home page. Next, we are going to add an about page. Okay, so this is actually very similar. We'll create a template file, a new view, and then a new URL. So template, view, URL. Okay, so first of all, you are going to exit the current environment. So quit the server with Ctrl plus C, and then create a new template called about.html. So in that previous case, we created home.html. So here we are going to create about.html. So in the command line, you include within the brace pages dollar, you are going to access with the template. So touch template slash about.html. Okay, so this is actually going to populate the short HTML headline within the HTML tag about page. Okay. So about adding an about page, you are going to get access to the django.views.generic template template view, and in the class home page view, you are going to access with the template view. Okay, so you are going to give the template name home.html, and then in the about pages view, you are going to give the template name as about.html. So this is the difference between adding the home page as well as the about page. Okay, what you have to do, you have to connect it to the URL. So you have to point it to the URL function. So from django.urls import path. Okay, so whenever you are giving the import path function, you have to define the patterns as well as the path. Okay, and then you have to go with from dot views import home page view comma about page view. Okay, so URL patterns with the case of path function, you are going to go with the about page view as underscore view name equal to about. Okay, and then with the case of the path, with the case of home page view, you are going to give the name as home. With the case of about means the name, you should give it as about. With the case of home page view means you should give the name as home. Okay. And then you close the square brace. After creating the about page, you are going to navigate through the URL http 127.0.0.1:8000. Now you are going to get the about page. So this is what's the difference between a home page and an about page. Yes, it is quite similar. So you have to create a new template, new views, new URL, and you have to create the home page or maybe about page. After creating all these templates, the real execution of Django lies with the extending of the templates, because only then you will able to research the functions associated with it. So if you think about most websites, there is content that is repeated on every page, maybe the footer or maybe the header. For example, if you have a website which is going to update the university marks, okay, so you will have the logo of the university on every application what you are trying to do. So you will have the repeated functions. So if the developers could have one place for the header code, definitely you need not have to repeat it once again. Okay, for example, if the developers have one particular place for footer, so he or she cannot, there is no need for repeating it once again. Okay, so we have to create a base.html file what we are going to repeat. Okay, so it contains header with link to our first two pages. Okay, so we could name this file using this base.html. Okay, so you're going to exit the current server with control plus C. What you're going to do, you're going to include this command line within the braces pages dollar. You're going to access the template. So that's templates slash C base.html. This is not home.html or about.html. This is base.html. Okay. So it's what you can see, you can picturize this Django as a very minimal templating language. We can add links, we can add logic in our templates. So that we can add anything with our custom template tags as well. In order to add the URL links in the project, you can actually go with the built-in URL template tag. Generally, it makes the URL pattern name as an argument. Okay, so the URL root, you can include the header function. You're going to go with the reference file, the tag href. Okay, you're going to access with the home function, and then you're going to end with the header. Okay, this is actually the block content and then the end block content. So at the bottom, we add a block tag called the content. Okay, blocks can be overwritten by the child templates via inheritance, via the extension function. So it's actually optional to name our closing end block as well. So you have to go with the end block. Okay, if you prefer to do so, it generally improves the reader of the authors. Okay, maybe you can include this the reference file with the home function, and then you are going to close the header function. Okay, so this is all about extending templates with a block function and end block function. After that, what you are going to do, you are going to update this home.html and about.html using this base.html. Okay, so you are going to go with the extends base.html, and then the block content, you are going to include the home page and then end block content. Okay, and then you are going to extend with the base.html block content with the case of about page. See, for the first case, this is home page, and the second case, this is about page, and then you are going to go with the end block content. So in the same case, you can access it simultaneously. When you are going to go with 127.0.0.1:8000, you are going to go with home page. But if you type after 8000, you type slash above, then you will get the above page. So this you are making the small modification. You are making a small extension to the home page in order to get the above page. So for creating all these things, you need a base.html file. You can add additional templates on the top of it in order to make your Django project more reliable as well. Very important thing the entire session is that you have to include as many test functions as possible in order to test its reliability, its authentication, and its privacy. Okay, so it's very important to add tests and get the habit of always adding them to our Django project. Maybe you can say the code without test is broken as designed. Okay, so you should have a periodic evaluation. Like for example, even with the class. For example, if I'm teaching the lectures continuously without any test, so I think probably for the next class, definitely I will have a short class test. So without the class test, the entire session becomes meaningless. So code without test is broken as designed, and writing test is very important because it automates the process of confirming that the code works better as expected. Okay. So definitely our Django project would grow in size, maybe hundreds, maybe thousands, 10,000s, maybe millions. Okay. So we can make changes to the code, we can add new features, we can update the existing ones, delete the unused ones, try to make a new one. Okay, the broken links, we should ignore it. We have to make a new one. Okay, and we should include like a semi-automatic test as well as automatic test as well, so as to expect a specific piece of our project to behave and do the make the computer do the checking for us. So this is how you make the test, and you are going to program make the evaluation of the test more programmable as well. So Django, if you can discuss, it's actually it's very reliable, and the testing tools, we need not have to add the external means. It already has a built-in testing tools for writing and running tests. So within the Django app, it already provides a test at py file. So what you're going to do, you're going to open this test function. So you're going to include from django.test into simple test case. So in the simple test, what you're going to do, you're going to access with the test underscore home underscore page underscore status code. So you're going to set the response equal to self.line, and you're going to ascertain equal status code being assigned accordingly, and then you're going to define the test about page status code. So response you're going to assign as self.line.get. Okay? So you're going to assert the equal response.status code. So only with the creation and the assurance of the test case, so you can make sure that the test is being done periodically for evaluating objects. And then with the case of the simple test case, we are not using a database. Okay, suppose if you are using a database, then you should include a test case function. So we are using simple test case. So if you are using a database, means a simple test case, normal test case function is needed. Okay. So what you are going to do, you are going to run the test, you are going to build the server by pressing Ctrl plus C, and in a manages.py test file, you are going to create a test database for A1. Okay, so system check identify no issues. So this is actually a deployment function. Okay, you are going to go with the deployment function. So the system is going to check, and it is when it is identifying no issues, so you can run two tests in a very small amount of time. And then you get OK, destroying test space for allies default. Okay, so this is how you are going to create a test case, and then you are going to destroy the test database for default. Okay. So this is the future of the Django with the case of get and wait buckets. So you are going to include the command line for the case of tracking the changes with git and pushing them with the git bucket. So within the braces, we include pages, other git initialization. So we are going to track the changes with the git, and then you are going to push them with the git bucket. Only thing, git is not really available, but with git bucket you can do things about it. So use git status to see all upload changes, and then you are going to git add minus e. Okay, so in the command line, $git status, after initialization, you are going to go with $git status, $git add minus hyphen k, okay. And then commit hyphen m, you are going to go with the initial commit function. And then with the case of git bucket, the same way like our hello world app, you are going to go with the new repository functions. So in the pages app, you are going to go with the creation of the new repository. So you want to create a Bitbucket page, okay? Bitbucket create page. So you're going to give the repository name pages app. So in the next page, look for the commands under step 2, connect your existing repository to the bucket. So make sure include a readme no function, and then version control you select git, okay, and then you go with the create, okay. But only thing after this step, you are going to go with step 2, which is connect your existing repository in the Git package. This was what we are talking about. So let's push some bits in your bucket with the Git bucket. Okay, you will have the SSH, okay, and then you have the local Git repository of the Git bucket. You have a path, and then you have the adding the version as well. So in the source, you will have all these things. And then the bit bucket, we are going to push with the help of $git remote add origin git at Amazon bitbucket.org. So you are going to go with this function, because I have created a new file called WS Vincent. You can actually create your own name, and in that you are going to go with the pages app.git function. So after this function, you are going to go with $git push hyphen u origin master. So this is how you are going to replace the name with the Bitbucket username, and then you are going to go with the origin function. So this is how you compare the local address, the production server settings, okay? Because you cannot change the local host address, okay? And to make sure that the site is available on the internet so that everybody can be able to see it, so you can deploy this code to the external server so that you can use it to see our site, okay? Maybe we can put this code into production, okay? Local code lives only on our computer, but in the case of production state, it is made available to the external server so that everybody can use it, everybody can get it according. There are many server providers available, but definitely in the the subsequent topics we will be discussing about the Heroku app, normally for beginners, for Django beginners, for creating smaller projects. It's being widely used, it's being an external server where you can access it and view the codes accordingly, and you can make the deployment process more easier as well. This is the Heroku app which we are talking about. We are going to create a free new Heroku app on the website. So normally when you sign up the feature, then definitely you will give it a confirmation key. Here Heroku will redirect you to the dashboard section of the site. So we have created an account, and then you will have these pages. You will have Ruby, PHP, Node.js, JS, Python function, Java, Go, Azure, and then Scala function. And then you can create a new app. For the case of installing Heroku's command line interface, CLI, we can deploy it accordingly. With the case of command plus T on a Mac, or maybe if you press Ctrl and then T on the Windows, we can make sure that the Heroku version is being correctly installed in the virtual environment. So what you are going to do, you are going to go with the same command, $brew install. In that line we have brew line, okay. Here you include $brew install Heroku, okay. So you see the Heroku CLI page to correctly install either maybe the 32-bit version of the Heroku or maybe the 64-bit version of the Heroku. So, in the case of Windows or maybe Mac platform, it's much easier. For example, in the Linux, there are specific install instructions. So, when you make sure that the installation is complete, you close the current command line tab, and you are going to go with the initial tab. Okay. So, the type the command Heroku login and use the email and password for Heroku. For example, within braces you include $Heroku login. So the email what you have given you should enter, okay, and after that you include the password, okay. So after that it gets logged in to the account and it will show you how to create a new pages. With the case of including the additional files, you are going to update the pipeline at log. And you are going to make a new procedure file, okay, and then you are going to install the gunicorn as a web server and make the changes accordingly with the settings.pyml function. So this is how you are going to install with the Python version. Maybe the current version is 3.7, okay. So you are going to go with pip file which requires Python underscore version equal to 3.7. You are going to update the pip file and then you are going to create the new procedural file. You are going to install the gunicorn and then you are going to update these changes in the settings.py file. So this is how you are going to run the pip environment log function. Command line within the pages, within braces pages, $pip and log function. You are going to include the command line, okay, $touch procedural file. So in the procedural file, you are going to go with the gunicorn pages underscore project dot wsc.log. So after creating another pip function, you're going to go with a new procedure file, and then next what you're going to do, you're going to install the gunicorn function and make these changes in the pip in the settings file. Okay, so you're going to include the command line, okay, within the braces pages pip and install gunicorn. This is the version 19.9.0. And you are going to go with the other host within braces, span brace, you are going to include span. Okay. So normally it will have the wsc8.py file. Normally with the creation of any new project, Django will try to access the wsc8.py file. So this is considered to be the topmost priority where you get access to the pages underscore project. So these are nothing but the additional files that you should write on intro when you are trying to access the home page with the case of adding the new files as well. So with the case of allowed host, generally it will prevent any intruder from generally accessing our files or media folders. So it will prevent the header attacks. So normally in place of HTTP, you can use HTTPS for secure and analytical features. So definitely it will have a safe web server configurations. So we can use the asterisk star, which means that all domains are acceptable to make the things. So you are going to include the command line within braces pages, color git status, and then add hyphen a, and then commit. You are going to go with the new initial setup. So you are going to make a new commit, new updates for Heroku deployment. And after that, you push it to the bitbucket. How do you push it to the bitbucket? You are going to include this command line, within braces pages, $git push origin master, hyphen u origin master. So this is how you are going to push it to the bitbucket, and you can create a new repository file. So this is the independent work. I think the same has been posted to you in the Google class. I think everybody would have viewed it. I'm posting this once again in the chat window so that everybody will get to know about it. And I expect the PowerPoint slide with the description, the syntax, the code, a sample program, and its output, so that you will definitely get to know how you use Python, and definitely the basics of Python would help you install the Django version, and how to create a home page, how to create an about page, and how to go with a based on HTML file.